Today in this video, I want to talk to you about one of the other concepts that is new to the PL300 exam and that you want to make sure you are familiar with so that you aren't surprised when you sit for that exam. Stay tuned. All right, so here I have the official study guide, the official documentation from Microsoft regarding that PL300 exam. Now, this document is one you do want to make sure that you review in its entirety before you sit for that exam. If I scroll down this document, you can see it's broken up into various sections. And one of the first sections shows us here, the exam has changed. Microsoft will make updates to the exam to continue to make sure that the exam is testing on the skills needed to be considered a Microsoft Power BI data analyst. So if I click into this section here, it's going to take me down to the place in the document where I can see what skills will be on that exam if I am sitting for it after April 23rd of 2024. Now, if you've never looked at this study guide document, I highly recommend that you review this entire thing before you schedule and decide to take that exam to make sure you know what you're getting yourself into in regards of what content's going to be on that question, what the exam content breakdown is, so how, you know, much each section is weighted. So we can see here that prepare the data, model the data, visualize and analyze the data, have the potential to make up to 25 to 30% of your exam. The fourth group here, and these are referred to as functional groups, can make up to 15 to 20% of your exam. So deploy and maintain assets is what I want to draw our attention to, or deploy and maintain items as it's now called. But in this section, as we scroll down and get here, I want to take a look at this last objective here, manage semantic models. Within this objective, there are 5 bullet points or 5 skills that you really need to be familiar with for this objective on how to manage your semantic models. So configure automatic page refresh is the option I want to talk about today. And this option is not a feature that is really necessarily new to Power BI, but it is one that's new to the PL300 exam. So you want to make sure you are familiar with this. Let's head over to the Power BI desktop and take a look at a sample model to take a look at configuring automatic page refreshes. All right, so here I have open a Power BI report that contains some AdventureWorks data and about 5 visuals, couple slicers. So for this demonstration, if you wanted to follow along or explore these settings and these options in the Power BI desktop with me as well, you can use any Power BI report that you have that is connected to a direct query source. So in order to enable and configure automatic page refresh, you must have a report that is connected to a direct query source. That is where you will need to go. And this is why you will need to configure the settings to tell how frequently to update the report with the data that has changed or with new data. So when using automatic page refresh, you are going to configure this by going to your visualization pane, to the Format Your Report Page button, and then down at the bottom here, you can see the page refresh section. So we will toggle this on and open this section up and see a couple of settings here to explore. So the first one that we see is refresh type. Now, there are 2 refresh types available for you to choose from when you are configuring your automatic page refresh for your direct query sources. You can choose to have auto page refresh at a fixed interval or for change detection. Now, the first option here, automatic page refresh, is the option that you will use when you want to update all visuals in the report based on a constant interval, a second, a few seconds, 5 minutes, 20 minutes, whatever that may be. The range is going to be from 1 second to 30 minutes. So let's take a look at this option here first, and then we'll dive into change detection. So right now you can see the default setting for this is set currently to 30 minutes. It will refresh the page every 30 minutes by default. The lowest interval is going to be down to 1 second. So you could set this to 1 second if your administrator, your Fabric admin, has enabled that to be allowed, that low refresh rate of 1 second has been allowed. Now you can see this here by clicking show details, and we can see here, okay, the admin has enabled for users to set the refresh as low as 1 second. You can see the actual rate here, and it's updating here. You can see it's kind of changing and what that will actually be. So you can kind of see that in live time, what the actual rate will be based on a few things, a machine and that rate that has been set, as well as how much data is in there. Now, a couple of things to note with this. If I were to, let's say that my report, the data connected to my report, isn't actually updating every second, then there should be no reason for you to set it this low. So I know that, and we know that this data, the AdventureWorks data, isn't updating that frequently. So I would want to change this to something else. And let's hypothetically say that this data is really updating every few minutes. I could set this to refresh the page every minute, every 2 minutes, every 5 minutes, whatever we wanted that to be. But your refresh rate should be the actual refresh rate of the data. So if the data is not updating as frequently as every 2 minutes, then we don't want to set it at this. So the actual refresh rate is typically going to be a little bit longer than the selected interval. So that's something to keep in mind. So if my data is refreshing, you know, every 4 or 5 minutes, then that's something that I'd want to consider as I'm setting this. Now, let's go ahead and take a look here now at change detection. So I'm going to switch the settings here to change detection. Now, I currently have a configuration here for change detection, but I'm going to go in and change this here in just a second. So the change detection option, the refresh type, allows you to set up your refresh, set up your page so that it's going to refresh the visuals based on any changes it has detected in the data, as opposed to setting it at an automatic fixed rate or an automatic fixed interval rate here. So that is the difference with the change, the first option here, automatic page refresh, or at the fixed interval that you specify, and change detection. Change detection is going to be based on the data that you choose. And so here I have a measure showing profit, and it's changing every minute. We can go in here and click edit change detection. So again, here you can see I have an existing measure in place. Now you can only have one measure. You can only set up one specific change detection for this particular page for your automatic page refresh. You cannot create multiple in here and have that as what your automatic page refresh is based on. So I could keep the existing measure here and modify the changes. Currently, I have my profit measure in here and it's checking for changes every minute, but I could go in and possibly change that. So let's say instead of basing it on profit, I wanted to base it instead on my total sales. I can drag and drop that measure in, and then we can base this change detection on that total sales measure. Now, something to keep in mind, a couple things to keep in mind here, really. When you are using change detection, you can go in here and change this by the seconds, by the minutes, and by the hours. So again, just like we specified for the automatic page refresh, you will not want to set this up to change any sooner than the data is actually refreshing, because it is going to potentially run into some errors if it is trying to refresh in the middle of it as it's trying to look for changes and detect those changes when those changes haven't occurred yet. So you want to define how often Power BI will check for those changes. And that's the interval on which Power BI will calculate the measure and see if there have been changes. Now, as a reminder, only one change detection measure is allowed for each model, for each report page and the automatic page refresh that you're setting up for that model. Now, a couple of things, considerations, and limitations to keep in mind. When this is enabled, Power BI is constantly sending queries back to your direct query source. And after that query is sent, there is a slight delay before the data is returned. And for shorter intervals or shorter refresh intervals that you configured, you want to confirm that the queries are successfully returning your query data within the configured interval. If your data isn't being returned back into the report visuals within that interval, your visuals are going to update less frequently than configured. So these considerations apply to both the change detection options as well as the automatic page refresh at a fixed interval. I can go ahead here and modify this here now to, I'll modify this to every 5 minutes just so we can see a clear update. I click apply, give it a moment, and we should see those changes take place over here in the page formatting settings here under page refresh. And we do see total sales measure checking every 5 minutes. Again, so make sure that you are keeping that in mind, that as a best practice, your refresh interval should match the actual refresh rate, should match the rate at which you expect new data to arrive. And so if your data is updated at the source every 20 minutes, your refresh interval should not be less than 20 minutes. If the data arrives every 5 seconds, then you shouldn't set it less than 5 seconds. So that's something you want to keep in mind. Make sure that you review all of the documentation regarding that PL300 exam, specifically the study guide and all of the different concepts listed, and be familiar with them all. Make sure that you review the documentation on automatic page refresh. There are quite a few settings that have to be enabled by your tenant administrator, but that is not something you have to be worried about or that you are going to be tested on that PL300 exam. You are expected to understand and know the differences between the features and options and settings available to you in the Power BI desktop and the Power BI service. I hope this video provided some clarity and improved your understanding of those automatic page refresh settings when you are working with direct query sources. If you haven't already, make sure to hit that like and subscribe button below to stay up to date with all of the videos that we post. My name is Angelica Chukwun, and I'll see you in the next one.